So I'm first generation immigrant. I come from China. And I'll tell you why I decided to leave China. I was the top student all through, starting from kindergarten, believe me. I was always the number one. Kindergarten, elementary school, junior high, senior high, I was accepted by the Tsinghua University, arguably the best university in China, without entrance examination. And there I am, first year college student, not thinking about going outside China at all. I have a bright future with me. Then what happened? 1989, okay. So I was first year college student. 1989, in April, we went on to Tiananmen Square to hand this petition letter to the government to demand a little bit democracy. And that's it. So we walked 10 kilometers or 20 kilometers to landed in the Tiananmen Square, and then we waited overnight for, because we know there's a major meeting of the government. We have our petition. There's three of the students' representatives waiting to hand this to the government. The next morning, we want them to just accept this letter and to have a discussion about democracy. And you can see all the leaders on top of this great wall with the binoculars looking at thousands of us and looking and looking. And we were just basically shouting, come pick up the letter, freaking letter, but nobody come, okay? And that, it was lasted all day, and they didn't even bother to send a single representative or secretary to come to accept our letter. So that started the entire Tiananmen demonstration, and I was there for 2 months, sleep on the ground most of the time. It was, for those of you who are probably too young to know that, at that time, it was just tragic in the end how this ended, okay. I was there for 2 months, and then the day my mother just got me home is when actually I lucked out, it was a crackdown. So it ended tragically with a lot of conflict. People died, soldier died, people died, students died. And at that moment, I said, I need to leave this country. I wanted something that at least you can have an open discussion about something. It's not you are... I grew up saying, live to 10,000 years of Chairman Mao. You know, that is written in our textbooks, and that is the moment I realized I need to rethink all these years of education. That's the sort of the political motive. And all the seniors in my university are coming, you know, finding ways to get out of China to actually coming to United States. The other thing is technology back then in China was I was biology major, so we were really primitive. PCR is invented in United States and being widely used. There we are learning this. We have three water baths, each one of us taking tubes, you know, every 30 seconds to another water bath, whereas here it's already run by machine. So I thought I want to learn interesting science, and I want to be able to have a little bit of freedom in terms of what I say. So here I am. I was by all means super lucky. I got accepted by Columbia University and did my PhD with a Nobel laureate, Richard Axel. And I can be very self-congratulatory because Richard, in his Nobel lecture, two-thirds of work he described is after he cloned the olfactory receptor, and those are my work, okay? And I went to do a postdoc with Mark Tessier Levine in Stanford, who is now Stanford president. And I got a job at Duke University, and I'm doing well, very well. I have very well funded, as Bob introduced me, that I can even be saying something that I consider myself, I can be considered as a leader in the field of somatosensation with the promise of finding cures for chronic pain. So enough about me. So why are we, and I'm certainly knows how privileged I am that I'm being able to come to this country, being welcomed, do so well, get my job. And I very much appreciate this. Now, why do we have this discussion? It's because there are people have this different voice of against immigration. To be honest with you, by me getting the job at Duke, did I take away a job from American? Absolutely, you bet, okay? Could I say that by me taking this job, that I made Duke better or made United better? No, absolutely not. I had no ability to do the control experiment. As a scientist, I could not do the control experiment that without me coming here, that what happens, right? Who's taking this job? Could I say that, okay, I have my lab, successful lab, I've created all these jobs, and I did wonderful things, but again, I cannot do the control experiment. Who am I to say that someone in my position may be doing even better, creating more jobs, even discover the treatment for chronic pain already while I'm still struggling to work on that? Again, in life, you cannot do control experiment. Therefore, I cannot draw conclusions. But, okay, let me tell you why it's not the discussion of whether immigration is good or bad, it's a moot point. Okay, that's a wrong discussion. Look at human history. If our ancestors didn't immigrate out of Africa, we'll all still be there, for Christ's sake, all right? We're all still stuck in that one continent. Thank God our ancestors wanted to move out of Africa and spread across the whole earth, right? And look at human history. When is the time that there's no migration? Okay, as the transport vehicle became available, that's just in human nature. We do have to understand the fear of immigration. Look at the history. The Spaniards invaded Mexico as that culture got, you know, eliminated, and the Westerns immigrated to the great America, discovered this new world, and the local Indians are not doing so well, let's put it that way. But on the other hand, you have to accept this is in our genes. Immigration, migration, leaving our places for whatever reason, either for something better or just out of curiosity. So there's no need to do something against human nature. Accept that as a fact. This is going to happen regardless you want it or not. If there's a will, there's a way. Okay, so this is the first thing. The second thing is you have to understand that in the modern era, what we can do is better than what Spanish did or, you know, the Western did to India, is we can work together, that the residents can find new opportunities such that it's a win-win situation. And there's no need to be fear of that. Just find opportunity and do better with it. Now, the second thing I want to stress is humans are the only creatures capable of perceiving us against them. Okay? Chimpanzees may have the ability to perceive self against others, but to consider a large community, I doubt it. Okay? Humans capable of consider us versus them, but in the end, we are also capable of perceive us as a whole, eliminate them. Okay? So by saying that, as me turning from immigrant to a resident, okay, so the new immigrant, for me, I could consider them as them. Me now belong to the us, right? But on the other hand, I'm babbling, but what I'm trying to say is, it's not letting the resident to consider immigrant as part of the us. It is also us to consider the ones who has the different opinions, those who are afraid of immigrants, those who think this is a bad thing, those who are scared of this, as part of us too. That's the only way to move forward, to understand each other's fears, and to eliminate those fears. And I think human beings are capable of doing that. That took the name of being inclusive is to include different opinions, including those people who you think are biased against you, who are discriminative. Because that's how we can all be inclusive and think of things together, work together, and really let the humanity shine through. And I'll end up here.